Her assumption to the presidency was met with applause, coming on the heels of President Joseph Estrada's ouster amid plunder allegations.
She was perceived as the answer to the corrupt administration of ERAP. She really is very competent, and people were saying that we need somebody like her who can actually govern and, you know, make the economy grow.
But it didn't take long before the situation took a turn for the worse. Doubts began to surface after a failed coup attempt and allegations of corruption against her husband.
I have decided not to run for president during the elections of 2004.
Her credibility also took a beating after she reneged on a promise not to run for president in 2004. After she won by a million votes, came allegations of vote rigging.
Hello. Hello, guys.
Ma'am.
Hello. Nag-usap kayo ni Alali Adana.
Ma'am.
An audio recording of Arroyo supposedly speaking to Election Commissioner Virgilio Garciliano spread like wildfire.
I am sorry.
Arroyo was forced to apologize, but people were angry by then.
The situation.
10 of her appointed officials resigned. Impeachment complaints over the betrayal of public trust were filed every year for the next 4 years, citing electoral fraud, plunder, and human rights violations. Her allies in Congress made sure the complaints wouldn't prosper. But Arroyo faced new challenges when Benigno Aquino III became president. He constantly took a swipe at the previous administration.
Yung mga kababayan na ho natin korup sa Pilipinas, kagagara ng kotse, kamamahal, katutulin. Pero pag ginustong tumakas, ang ginagamit wheelchair.
Arroyo was arrested for electoral sabotage in 2011. Graft charges were also filed over the NBN-ZTE deal. Arroyo was denied medical treatment abroad, and her health continued to deteriorate. The court granted her bail in 2012, but she was arrested again in October, this time for plunder over the alleged misuse of PCSO funds.
Orders the immediate release from detention of
the very case dismissed by the Supreme Court on Tuesday. Arroyo was elected congressman twice while in detention. She continues to face graft and electoral sabotage charges. But considering her friendship with President Rodrigo Duterte, it remains to be seen how her comeback will change the political landscape. Gigi Grande, ABS-CBN News.